Hey everyone, in this video I want to talk about how social media has made dating and relationships miserable, and how it only seems to be getting worse. Social media has made the world hyperconnected at an emotional level that has never before been experienced in human history. Using the internet as a platform, social apps started off as a way to find the hot girls on campus, stay connected to family or friends, and promote professional profiles for work. However, they've morphed into a massive engine that fuels itself on emotions, dopamine, and FOMO. Positive or negative behaviors never propagated quickly or far before social media. And broadcast media like newspapers, TV, and radio primarily influenced our shared views and behaviors. But now social apps can drive new trends, views, and behaviors to a global audience in real time. But all to what cost to our humanity and relationships. In this video, I want to focus on some of the dating and relationship consequences of social media. I think this is a really important topic of conversation, especially now as younger generations become increasingly connected and dependent on these social apps. I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. Let's get into it. Before social apps and online dating apps, men and women generally met through in-person interactions. They met physically and conversed, which may attract a romantic interest to see each other again. If a date arose, especially for strangers, they knew nothing about the other. So dating was discovering who the other was, their values, occupation, travel, interests, personality, etc. The critical point is that the information came directly from the other in conversation. Sometimes the person was known and recommended or pre-qualified by friends and family. But mostly the date started off with having very little knowledge about the other person. Additionally, when people get to know each other through in-person conversations and activities, they are generally more drawn to the other person and less judgmental. In the age of social apps and a broader internet presence, both men and women, but mostly women, become cyber detectives, searching deeply into all aspects of the other person, looking at and judging everything the person has ever posted or been tagged in. And this all happens before any in-person dates and may continue through the early dating process. This can have positive benefits, especially if the person has done illegal or bad things or hold extreme views, the classically described dodging a bullet. However, the small positives are outweighed by the negatives, and men especially fall victim to the negatives. For example, women may prejudge a man's social status, occupation, or financial state as being unacceptable without ever getting to know the man, just going off internet information. Women can also imagine red flags or icks on social information taken out of context and reject them. Women may even prejudge a man based on his follower count. If low, he must be shy or socially unsuccessful, and if high, he must be a player. Women will even judge the women he is socially connected to. For example, how beautiful the women are in the pictures, and if women leave flirty comments. The net negative effect is that women reject men they may have been highly compatible with, without investing time in conversation with that person. High-value men especially are not going to waste time curating their online presence. So social profiles are not a reliable way to judge others. Women have always gone through a subconscious process of a relationship qualification with men. The process goes through the following four steps. Number one, attraction, like physical looks, financial status, chemistry, and compatibility. Number two, qualification. Is this person valuable or qualified by others? Can they back up or substantiate what they say? Number three, social proof. The viewpoints of friends, positive or negative. Number four, indicate interest. Flirt, ask the guy out, a 3-second stare, or a direct message. These steps often continue throughout the early dating process. Before the internet, these stages were done in person. But now, in the age of social apps, all of these stages are mostly done online. The negative is that steps 1 to 3 can all be based on faulty, incomplete, or misleading information about the other person. Perception and reality can be quite different when judging others based on their curated social media content. One of the biggest complaints of men is that they attend a first date and the woman looks nothing like her dating or online social images. And the trap for women is that it's easy for men to project a much higher value than reality. The natural process for women to identify prospective men who could become a loving lifetime partner is being distracted, defeated, and undermined by social media. It also creates more competition among women for the top 20% of high-value men, both single and married. Even playboys, while distasteful to women, are seen as desirable on social media because they are pre-qualified by other women. Social media is polluted with highly curated, reality-distorted profiles and influencers pushing their best lives and enviable lifestyles. It's intoxicating because who doesn't want to live their best life, whatever that concept really means. But it creates a sense of dissatisfaction and envy, especially in women, and it flows into their dating lives and relationships. Elevated expectations in life make it difficult for prospective partners to meet them. Women in their 20s are less likely to invest in men on the chance that they will eventually become successful. They want the final product, the high value and status on day one, which is very difficult for men in their 20s to achieve at that stage in life. It also puts enormous pressure on men to even be at a level worthy of dating a woman. Some women even explicitly state on their dating profiles that they are only looking for high value men. Social media is making women preoccupied with superficial things, skewing what is real and important for them and making them less happy. Herd mentality is very common amongst humans, and even more common amongst women. In the past, it was an important survival adaptation, but now with social media, it might be our demise and destruction. Social media and dating apps are changing women's perceptions of themselves as more physically beautiful and attractive than they are in reality. In some ways, it's understandable when thousands of men pursue women on dating apps. They receive unsolicited messages and likes on non-dating apps and supplicating messages from men. This obviously affects their self-perception. Before social media and dating apps, women received a fraction of these modern approach counts, as men had to approach and compliment a woman in person. There was a cost to this for men, so most women received few. But in the digital age, there's no cost to sending messages or supplicating to a woman's vanity in hopes of a sexual reward. The negative of this is that women reject compatible partners in pursuit of higher value options, but because of their status, have many options of their own. This leads these women into hookups, high body counts, and situationships, where they will be kept on the fun list but will not progress to wife status. Additionally, this elevated self-perception is promoting monkey branching and stripping women of their natural femininity and desire to provide equal value and accountability in a partnership. The use of AI is already impacting social media and further damaging male and female dating and relationships. A few points of concern is that number one, AI is woven into the algorithm, which dictates what people see and what they are alerted to. This further narrows what people are seeing and can change perceptions. Second, as AI develops and becomes more human-like, people may get their needs met by AI personas and influencers and no longer see a need to build connectivity with a human partner. And third, and most concerning, is the rise of CGI and deepfakes used for money-making schemes and misleading people about the truth and what is reality. The scary part is that we are only in the very early stages of this technology, and who knows how it will progress and affect the future of humanity. With diminishing costs to produce these deepfakes in AI influencers over time, our future online worlds will be polluted with non-humans, which will inevitably affect real-life male-female relationships. Monkey branching is essentially lining up a new relationship without fully exiting the current one. The monkey brancher keeps using their current partner for sex, validation, or companionship while actively seeking out better options. At some point, they'll feel comfortable enough that the new partner will work out. So they decide to let go of their current partner and swing over to the new one. Social media makes this easy to find alternative dating or relationship prospects. Women with even the smallest presence on social media receive direct messages from men seeking some type of sexual encounter or relationship. Of course, they don't have to answer, but the temptation is certainly present. And temptation can win when there's the smallest crack or misunderstanding in the current relationship. The problem is, it's so cheap to approach online for both men and women. Sending a DM, there's almost zero cost in failing. With zero cost, people, especially women, want the benefits of commitment, but reject the sacrifices of commitment that make it work. Women also know how to game the system. The more they share their lives and show more skin and sexual content, the more men will reach out. And the more men that reach out, the more likely they are to encounter new attractive prospects. Monkey branchers tend to be people influenced by money, status, and image. They spend a lot of time engaging on social media and are most likely to express constant dissatisfaction. We need to ask ourselves, why am I posting this sexual photo of myself? Why am I sharing this bikini photo of myself on the beach when I'm in a relationship? Is it to gain attention from other men? Is it so I can gain admiration and feel good about myself? And why do I need this attention from others? Am I trying to send a covert message? And importantly, how will this make my partner feel? Another consequence of social media is low effort dating. This means that either the male or female or both are not pushing forward the relationship's momentum and development. This is again caused by women having record levels of male attention and choice. Women with a roster or a number of supplicating men who do things for them have no reason to develop and commit to a long-term monogamous relationship. And high-status men with regular online approaches from women know how to manage women for sexual conquest with minimal investment. They are not motivated to progress the encounter to a deeper level because they get what they want with such little cost. Whether it's a consequence of too much choice, elevated self-perception and value, or other factors amplified by social media, a successful long-term relationship is unlikely when both parties exert an imbalance in effort over time. Social apps are designed to suck people in and to be addictive because their measurement of success is engagement and time spent on their platforms. Perhaps they started out with better intentions, but the positive return on value is difficult to define and measure these days, while the negative aspects are definitely stacking up and changing society. Ultimately, I think one of the most important things in life is our ability to have perspective and control over our lives, including our feelings, emotions, thoughts, actions, etc. When those get hijacked by an opposing influence that doesn't have our best interest at heart, that's when things go wrong and become harmful. Personally, I don't think social media has our best interest at heart, nor our dating and relationships. Ultimately, social media is a tool, and you have to decide for yourself how and if you want to use it. That's it for me on this video. If you like the work that I do, please give it a big thumbs up. It really helps the algorithm get it out to more people. Thank you again so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.